Welcome back. In this third lesson, we're going to take a look at how roles get assigned and how you can use roles to create a highly organized and fluid timeline.
Now that you understand how roles and subroles work, knowing how to assign them is the key to organizing your audio.
As I scroll through this event, you'll see that all my clips are one of three colors indicating their role, either dialogue in blue, music in green, and effects in teal. If you're wondering how these roles are assigned in the first place, there's some new options in the import window. Other than the new flat, darker look, this window is functionally the same as previous versions of Final Cut Pro 10, but with one new addition. In the import options pane to the right, you'll notice a section labeled Audio Roles. In previous versions of Final Cut Pro, audio was automatically assigned one of three roles during import, either dialogue, music, or effects, but you had no ability to override these role assignments until after your clips were imported. As you can see from this pop-up, you can now choose the role assignment for any selected clip in the import browser. With the menu set for automatically, Final Cut Pro does its best guess as to what the audio role should be based on the selected media content. I'll select the camera card from my Canon 5D to display its clip contents in the browser. Whenever you import video clips that contain audio, regardless of where it originated, Final Cut Pro will always assign the audio role as dialogue, even if there's no actual dialogue present in the clip. I'll select this folder of music. Some of the clips are being interpreted correctly as music, as indicated by the green color, but some of them are being interpreted as dialogue. I'll select them, then use the menu to assign them as music. Then click Import. Notice the clips were imported and are correctly role tagged as music, as indicated by their color. Roles can also be assigned after your clips are imported, and you can even create custom ones. I'll select this dialogue clip, right-click and choose Assign Audio Roles, Edit Roles. In this new window, called the Roles Editor, you can see both the video and audio role groups and their pre-assigned colors. To add a role, click the plus button for the role type. I'll add a video role and an audio role. I'll give this audio role a custom name and assign it a custom color. Then I'll delete the video role and click Apply. To assign that new role to a clip, right-click on it and choose the role from the menu. I'm now going to delete that role to show you how Final Cut Pro deals with it. I'm going to use a different method to call up the Roles Editor. I'll press Command 4 to reveal the inspector and view the clip in the audio configuration area. Here, we see the audio is assigned its new role, including its components, also called subroles. Using the menu on the component, I'll choose Edit Roles. Now, I'm going to delete the role and click Apply. You're given a warning that deleting this role will be removing it from any clip in your library that's using it. Because I know what I'm doing, I'll click Continue. The clip reverts to its automatically assigned dialogue role. You can also create custom subroles. A subrole is just what it sounds like. It's a subrole, and they're applied to individual audio components within a role group. By selecting this dialogue clip, you can see in the inspector that it has one subrole component that Final Cut Pro automatically assigned as Dialogue 1. I would prefer to label it for the character or the type of mic that was used on the set. The reason this is important is it allows me to create meaningful subrole labels that will appear in my timeline during sound editing. You'll see this shortly. For now, to create the new subrole, I'll open the Roles Editor and click the Add Subrole button to add it to the Dialogue Role group. I'll name it Steve and click Apply. Then, from the component menu in the inspector, I'll assign this subrole. In terms of workflow, I would then create a synchronized clip from the sound recorder and the camera. One new feature is this checkbox labeled Disable Audio Components on AV Clips. This checkbox will save you a step whenever you synchronize a clip that contains both video and audio with a clip that contains only audio. Most AV clips that are imported from your camera contain reference audio, not the high-quality audio from your digital recorder you intend on syncing with it. So by leaving this checked, the reference audio will be disabled automatically once the synchronized clip has been created. I'll click OK to create the synchronized clip. A new synchronized clip is created in the browser with a new badge in the upper left corner of the clip. Selecting the clip, then examining the audio configuration in the inspector, we can indeed see that the storyline audio, that is, the reference audio component from the camera, has been disabled. and only the components from the digital audio recorder are enabled. Notice that it's also labeled with my custom subrole. I took the time to show you this so we can end this lesson with a bang. Here I have an open project where I took the time to make sure that all my audio was assigned custom subroles prior to editing them into the timeline. In the timeline index, I'll reveal the subroles for the dialogue, and you can see there are now individual subrole lanes named for each character in the scene. The editor I'm about to hand this project off to will never have to guess which audio clips he or she is working with. And it gets even better. Let's say that I want to place these voiceover clips that currently exist in the Dialogue 2 lane into their own custom lane. At the bottom of the timeline index, click the Edit Roles button. Add a subrole to the dialogue group and name it VoiceOver. And click Apply. In the timeline, I'll select these clips, right-click, and assign them my custom subrole. The clips automatically flow into their new lane. And remember, these subrole lanes can be reprioritized at will, even during playback.
Okay.
Just imagine the shots we can pull off, Jill. Because of the larger lens build, there's a greater throw distance. How cool is that?
Wow. Steve, I have to say, I love that. It is so much more flexible and powerful than a track-based NLE.
So you likey.
I likey.
I think Apple has proven with this release that metadata is the best way to work with your audio.
I do. I agree.
If you take the time to properly tag your audio up front, working with your audio will be so much more flexible and you'll be able to work so much faster. In this final lesson about roles, I'm going to show you how to use them to do a final mixdown.